Hey, if you're a student or apprentice optician, I bet becoming an eye care professional is on your radar. And what better way than to take the leap, write your national certification exams, and become a licensed optician? Well, you're in luck, because in this video, we're gonna do a complete walkthrough of our flagship program, the Ultimate Apprentice Optician Study Guide, so you can see for yourself what it's all about and how it can help you achieve your goals. Hey, Sean Lessard here from Modern Optician, where we help student opticians reach their career goals through study guides, books, and video resources like this one. Remember, if you see value in this video, make sure to smash the thumbs up button below and consider subscribing. And don't forget, all of the links mentioned in this video will be in the description box down below. No matter what industry you're in, writing national certification exams can be loads of stress. And in the Ultimate Optician Study Guide, we've done all the work for you and laid out the exact recipe that hundreds of students just like you have used to be successful. All right, let's jump into the computer right now so that we can take a peek. All right, here we are inside the Modern Optician space. We're on the website and we're gonna go through the study guide in a second here. So you'll notice that we've got the page here that kind of describes all the different features of the study guide. And if I click get started here, it's going to bring me right into the space where if you were not registered yet, you would actually just register and you would get full access. However, in this case, I have already registered. So I will click resume course and I get brought right into the environment. So here, when we're starting off, we've got on the left-hand side here, we've got all the different pieces or parts of the study guide. You'll see that we've got the welcome, we've got the workbooks for apprentice opticians, we've got the question banks, the flashcards, and some resources. So why don't we start going through them one by one just to get a little sneak peek of exactly what you get and how it can be so useful. So the first thing here is the welcome, and we have a little bit of a blurb that describes exactly how to use all the individual parts of the study guide. We have a little bit of a blurb on the workbooks, on the question banks, and the flashcards. And you can read through that and it gives you some insight as to what the best way of using this is and how you can really, you know, use it for your success. Now, next tab are the workbooks, and you get all five of the apprentice optician workbooks, from ocular anatomy to optics to products to instrumentation and dispensing. So you get all five of them. So why don't we click on the ocular anatomy one and let it load up, and you here it is in kind of presentation mode, and you could click here to kind of make it visible on the screen. And the great thing is here is as I scroll through, you get the whole thing, and we can kind of scroll down. You'll see these are all the workbook pages, and at the end of it, as we scroll, you get the solutions and answers too, so you can check all your work. And the beauty thing here is that you'll notice here I can click this to download it so that I can have it on all my different devices and have easy access to it, or I could print it. And that's the main thing, the main way that this workbook is meant to be used, is to print it off, go through all the pages, answer them as best you can, do your research and find the answers, and that's all part of the learning experience. And then from there, you could check your answers, make sure everything looks good, you know, do a little bit more studying on the things you've missed. And then we could do it all over again because you could just print it off again and do it again. And of course, like I said, we've got the optics workbook, and as it loads, and you get the idea, and we've got all the other workbooks that you can go through as well. So there's hours and hours of study time here and great, great resources to help you when you're practicing for your national examinations, or even if you're just trying to get a leg up on some of your studies if you're in an actual opticianry course. Now, moving on to the next part are the question banks. And this is a great way to test your knowledge after you've gone through the workbooks. All right, so now I've gone ahead and I've clicked on the next part of the study guide, which is the question banks. And you'll see here that we have little quizzes arranged for anatomy, optics, products, instrumentation, and dispensing. And they're all 25 question quizzes. And it's drawing from a question bank of more than 1,000 questions. And these are all randomized, so you'll never see the same quiz twice. Which is great, right? Because you know you don't want to start memorizing your answers and it's not going to be that effective anymore. So here I've gone ahead and I've clicked on a ocular anatomy quiz, and I'll just show you one example here of
Okay, so the average axial length of the human eye is 23.5. And you'll see here, it tells you that it's correct. If I were to, let's purposely get one wrong here. So you can see the front third of the eye, which includes all the structures in front of the vitreous, is called, let's just call it the, we know this is wrong, however, we'll see that, you know, the correct answer is anterior segment. So as you're going through, there's no confusion as far as where you've gone wrong. You can see what that you've gotten the answer wrong. You can see what the correct answer is so that it, you know, it helps you in the future as well. Moving on to the next part of the study guide, you'll see that we have the digital flashcards, which is super cool because if you click here, you'll see we've got this loading up. I'll talk about this in a second. Who doesn't love flashcards? You remember when you were a kid, when you were learning your multiplication tables and different things? We always use flashcards. This is a great way to kind of, you know, go over the terms and different, you know, concepts within our field and just do a quick kind of recognition thing where you'll see the definition and then you can you can decide what you think that the definition is describing and then flip it to see the answer. So here you'll see that we have the resume or the restart. The reason this is here is because I've done this before and the deck is continuing from where I left off. If you hit resume, you won't see the same questions again or the same cards again because the deck hasn't been shuffled. If we hit restart, it'll reshuffle the deck and then we can kind of start fresh and it'll all be in different orders. This is great so that you don't get, you know, learn the order and start to memorize, and now again it's not being as effective as it can be. So let's go ahead and click resume here and you'll see the cards start popping up. So we get the definition, we click flip card and we see the answer. And of course we can keep doing this. We'll go to the next one and we could do the next one and we can keep going flipping the card and seeing what the answer is. This is so useful if you get some downtime and you want to do a little bit of studying, whether you're on the bus or on your lunch break or wherever you are. You can do this on the go, you could do it at home. It's super easy, it works on your laptop, it works on all your devices, and it's super, super handy. And last but not least is the resource tab. So in here I've organized some of the PDF resources that I use to make my products, like the study guides and the question banks. And even, you know, these are resources that I go back to all the time when I'm teaching my students, or even if I want to kind of review some of the concepts that I haven't looked at in a while. And I'm always adding to this this list. These are some things that you need to use in your studies. And, you know, we made them easily accessible here within the environment. And you can either save these to your device, you can print them off, or you can just leave them here because sometimes it's a lot easier to find what you're looking for if it's in one place. Just like, you know, just like the study guides, or sorry, the workbooks and the question banks, you're already coming to use these. Why not leave the resource here? And it can be read within here. So got a little bit of a blurb here about why we've chosen these. And you'll see that, you know, you have access to this PDF just like in the workbooks, but this is a great, great tool for ocular anatomy. I've read this several times and it's been very well laid out and gives you a great review of ocular anatomy. We have Introduction to Ophthalmic Optics, which I don't know if I have mentioned this before in other videos. However, this is, in my opinion, one of the best little PDF guides that was ever written. If you want to go over your optics concepts, there's nothing better out there than this guide. ANSI charts and whatnot. So anyways, you get the idea. We have all these different PDF resources and I'm always adding to it. Whenever I find something great, I put it in here. And of course, you know, if you want to be a better optician and you want to, you know, do well on your board exams, you're going to have to read. You know, the other guides that I've, you know, the other parts of the study guide, such as the workbooks and the question banks, are great for, you know, testing your knowledge and applying it. However, if you really want to be knowledgeable, you're going to have to go and seek out more study materials and more resources. And, you know, we've given you a little bit of stuff here to get started. Well, that pretty much does it for what's inside the study guide. And of course, you can bounce back and forth and you can go in every day and you can do different things. Maybe one day you'll do a quiz on ocular anatomy. Another day you'll do one on dispensing. Maybe you'll jump through the flashcards a little bit and test your knowledge. The great thing here is that it's all organized in a way that's all in one easy and convenient place to just keep learning and keep going back and forth until you're ready to take the leap and write your exams.
All right, I hope you've enjoyed our walkthrough of the Ultimate Apprentice Optician Study Guide. Remember, you have it in you to become an eye care professional. Just need a little bit of confidence and the right resources and tools. If you want more info on the program we covered today or any other resources to help with your success, make sure to visit modernoptician.com. And of course, if you have any questions about the program or anything we've covered in the video today, make sure to leave a comment down below and I'll make sure to get back to you. I hope you had a good time going through this video and I'll see you in the next one.